day again. So today we will discuss about middle latitude sailing, no? Ang combines with the plain sailing and parallel sailing. Pag-usapan natin dito yung mga components sa pagka-calculate ng middle latitude sailing, no? Kasama ang plain sailing and the parallel sailing. Kasi itong middle latitude na to ay halo na yan, yung middle latitude, the parallel sailing and the plain sailing, combination yung tatlo na yan. So pag sinabi natin na yung unang composition na ating pag-uusapan is the middle latitude, so when we say the middle latitude, is it is the mean latitude, no? Yan yung gitna ng latitude 1 and latitude 2. So there are two methods on how to solve for middle latitude na kailangan natin for the middle latitude sailing. Okay, so the first rule will be pagka nasa same hemisphere siya. Okay, parehas na hemisphere. So, ibig sabihin, parehas siya na north-north or parehas na south-south. No? So, pag ganito yung nakita nyo dun sa ating mga questions, no, the method will be latitude 1 plus latitude 2 divided by 2 will be your middle latitude. And for the different hemisphere naman, no, for example, north and south, or south and north, what you will do, yung latitude 1 natin, which is the greater value, ililess nyo yung smaller value and divided by 2. The naming would be kung sino yung mas malaki, no? For example, mas malaki si latitude 1 na north and mas maliit yung latitude 2 south. Ang naming will be derived from the greater value. Okay? So magiging north yan. Kung sino yung mas malaki, yun yung kukuhanin niyo yung name ng ating middle latitude. For the same hemisphere naman siya, kung nasan siyang hemisphere, yun yung kanyang magiging naming. For example, nasa north siya, they are both on the north, no, kasi same hemisphere sila, ilagay nyo north. Pagka nasa south naman, ilagay nyo south. Okay? Dito lang pinakaiba sa different hemisphere ay kung ano yung mas malaki na value, yun yung susundan nyo yung pangalan. And we have also the another component would be the parallel sailing. Okay, kung sa parallel sailing na you are on the same latitude, ito yung magiging formula nyo, no? Cosine latitude is departure divided by dilong. But, na-modify siya kasi magkaiba na yung, magka-different na yung ating latitude. Magkaiba na siya. Okay? So, ang mangyayari ngayon, mamumodify siya ngayon. So, cosine middle latitude, which we derive from here, okay, is equal to departure divided by dilong. Okay? But in the plain sailing, okay, kasi kailangan natin sa plain sailing yung departure, okay, to solve for the courses and distance. So, itatranspose natin siya para mahanap natin yung departure. So, by transposing the modified parallel sailing formula, the new formula will be departure is equal to d long times cosine middle latitude. Okay? Which the middle latitude na derive natin yan from here, from the first component ng middle latitude. Then, after you get the middle latitude, punta tayo sa second component, which is the parallel sailing formula. And we will use the modified formula. Bakit nagkaroon siya ng modified formula? Because sa parallel sailing na original na formula, it is on the same latitude. Now, on the modified formula, you are on the different latitude. So, by this, okay, the original na yung modified, excuse me, sorry, cosine middle latitude is equal to departure dilong, required yung departure sa ating plain sailing triangle. So, we will get the departure is equal to difference of longitude times cosine middle latitude. Okay? Pag nakuha na natin yung departure, we will go on to the next component, which is the, or the third component, which is the plain sailing. Okay? Okay, ang lagi natin tatandaan sa plane sailing is we are using the plane sailing triangle, as you can see here. It is a right plane triangle. Okay, yan ang third component natin. And kapag nakuha na natin yung departure from the parallel sailing, we will able to compute for the course and distance using the plane sailing triangle, no? So by just draw a triangle, no, kung saan man siyang quadrant, and pakitignan din yung ating quadrant na tutorials, no, ilalagay nyo lang yung mga components. Okay, ano yung departure, what is your difference of latitude. Now we will able to solve for the course and distances by the formula of this one. Saan no to na derive, no? By yung kuha natin, right plane triangle, or yung SOHCAHTOA, okay, na sine, so opposite over hypotenuse, cosine, angle, no, adjacent over hypotenuse, tangent, opposite over adjacent, okay, na pwede nyong ulitin doon sa ating module sa prelim, midterms, okay, lesson 5, navigational mathematics, kung paano na derive itong kuha na to, formula, which to solve for the course is equal to tangent, course is equal to departure divided by difference of latitude, no? And distance, solving for the distance is departure divided by sine course. This will be the components na gagamitin natin to solve for middle latitude sailing. Okay, so here we have the example problem for the middle latitude sailing. So, ship traveled from A, which is 02 degrees 30 minutes south, and 160 degrees 30 minutes west, and reach B, which is 01 degrees 15 minutes north, and 165 degrees 45 minutes west. So solve for the course and the distance traveled. So we are using the middle latitude sailing. Okay, tulad na lang sinabi ko yan, that is a combination of parallel sailing and plane sailing. So the first thing to do is solve for the difference of the first step is to solve for the difference of latitude and difference of longitude. Okay, so yung difference of latitude natin and longitude must be converted into minutes. Okay, converted into minutes. Okay, so the first thing to do is solve for the difference of latitude. Okay, so by here makikita nyo galing ka ng A and B. Okay, so 02 degrees 30 minutes south and 01 degrees 15 minutes north. Okay, lagay na rin natin dito yung ating longitude. Okay, 160 degrees 30 minutes west and 165 solve now for the difference of latitude and longitude using our calculators. Okay, yung ginagamit kong calculator is FX-224, okay, na calculator. So the rules, no, tandaan natin, no? So different name, so we add. Okay, 02 degrees 30 minutes 01 degrees 15 minutes equals the dilat, okay, is equal to 3 degrees 45 minutes. Then we multiply this into to convert into minutes. Okay, so 3 times 60 hours plus 45. So 225 yung ating kilat. And for solving our dilong, ay by the way, ano nga pala yung direction nito? No? Galing ka ng south ng 2 degrees. No? And umangat ka sa, you are going to north. North to yung ating gilat. Okay? And we will solve for the difference of longitude. Okay? Or our dilong. Okay? So, makikita nyo, they are all same name. Kaya subtract yan. Okay? Lagi nyo isusubtract yung higher value to the lower value. Okay? So, 155 degrees. 45 minutes. Less yung 160 degrees. Okay? 30 minutes. Less yan. Okay? So, the answer will be 5 degrees. 15 minutes. So, ano yung ating direction? Galing ka ng 160 degrees and pumunta ka pa sa mas higher na value na 165. So, pa-west ka. Okay? So, pag kinonvert yan, yung ating dilong would be 5 times 60 plus 15. So, the answer will be 315 minutes. Okay? Solve na natin for the sa dito. Masosolve na natin yung dilat and dilong. Then, malalaman na rin natin na kung nasaang quadrant yung ating calculation, no, for the plane sailing. So, ibig sabihin ay nasa kunsyang quadrant due to the design of the difference of latitude and longitude, nasa northwest quadrant tayo. Okay? So, ibig sabihin yung itsura niya, ay ganito yan here on the ganyan siya. So, from point A, ito yung point A natin, yung 02 degrees 30 minutes south, 160 degrees 30 minutes west. So, umakit tayo sa B. Ayan. Now, which is D? Yung B natin ay 01 degrees 15 minutes north, and yung longitude niya ay 165 degrees 45 minutes west. So, or we are looking for the course, no? Yung course niya, and the distance. Yan. So, pag ganyan yung itsura niya, okay? Actual. Yan. From point A to point B. So, here, kuha na natin yung difference of latitude and longitude. Now, we are going to do the first component, which is the middle latitude. Hahanapin natin yung middle part niya na latitude to solve for the departure. Okay, so here, the second step is to solve for the middle latitude. So, ang kukunin lang natin ay yung mga component ng latitude natin. So, yung A natin is 02 degrees 30 minutes south, and the B is equal to 01 degrees 15 minutes north. No, as you can see, they are on the different hemisphere. So, pagka nasa different hemisphere, what is the rule? No, ano yung gagawin natin? No, so latitude 1, okay, less yung latitude 2, okay, then you divide it by 2. Okay, so the higher value, okay, yung mas malaking value natin, ili-less natin yung lesser value. So 02 degrees 30 minutes south, no? Less yung 01 degrees 15 minutes north. So the answer here would be 32 degrees 30 minutes south, less 01 degrees 15 minutes, is equal to 1 degrees 15 minutes. Then you divide it by 2, your middle latitude will be 0 degrees 37 degrees. No? 37 minutes and 30 seconds. Okay? Now we will just convert the 30 second into a minute. So gagawin natin is to divide it by 60. Okay, so yung 30 divided by 60, so magiging 0.5. so 0 degrees 37.5. and the naming is the kung sino yung mas malaking value. So mas malaki yung value ng ating south, so the naming would be south. So the answer will be your middle latitude is equal to 0 degrees 37.5. no need to convert this one into a minute pag sa middle latitude. Okay, yan yung first component. And of course we will do the other component. Okay, so we will do of course the other component, no? Meron na tayong middle latitude, which is 37.5 south. Okay, so we will solve for the departure using the parallel sailing na formula, which is the modified. Sabi ko, bakit siya na modified? It is because you are moving to a different latitude, which is the modified formula for departure is equal to the long or difference of longitude multiplied by your middle latitude. No? So in your difference of longitude is equal to 315 na convert, no, times your middle latitude, which is 00 degrees 37.5 south. So your departure will be 315 times cosine. Ah, sorry. Ito dapat to cosine to. Guessing ko lang. Cosine middle latitude. So cosine 00 degrees 37.5 south. No, so times cosine 00 degrees 37.5 south is equal to 314.98. Yan yung ating departure. Now we will solve for the course and distances, no, using of course the third component, yung plane sailing. Okay, kasi kompleto na yung ating triangle, yung kanina, di ba, yung ganyan, nasa northwest tayo. Yan siya, no? Yung triangle niya, departure, your distance, your dilat, no? And of course your course. Okay, so here given na yung ating departure, given na yung ating dilat, no? Yung departure natin yan ay yung 314.98, and your difference of latitude na 225 yung na-convert kanina. So we can now solve for the course and distances using the plane sailing formula. formula. So by solving the course, we will use the formula tangent course is equal to departure over dilat, or derivation to sa Sokatowa, which is tangent is over, is equivalent to opposite over the adjacent. Okay, kaya makukuha na natin yung course. So by this, no, so 314.98 divided by your dilat na 225. Okay, so 314.98 divided by 225 is equal to 1.39. Okay, so here sa 1.39, huwag kalimutan, no, pressing the shift key, then tangent, para magiging tangent sa minus 1. Okay, makikita nyo yan in your answer. Okay, so magiging sagot dyan ay 54.46 northwest. So ibig sabihin, this is your quadrant, quadrantal figure notation yan. Now you will convert it on a true course, which is pagka nasa northwest ka. Okay, ito yung ruling ng ating quadrantal, no, pagka nasa northeast siya, as is. Okay, kung northeast ito, as is siya, 54.46. pero pagka nasa southeast siya ay less mo ng 180 degrees, pag sa southwest ay plus mo ng 180 degrees, at pagka sa na northwest siya ay ililess mo siya ng 360 degrees, para makuha mo yung true direction. So by calculation, 360 degrees less 54.46 is equivalent to 305.54 degrees true, or we can say, nga sabihin natin na 305 true. Okay, yan yung magiging sagot natin. And of course, we also can solve for the distance. Okay, pwedeng tatlong method yung distance natin. We can do calculation by Pythagorean theorem, we can do by the remaining component, yung sine over opposite over hypotenuse, or the other one, no? So by solving for the distance, we can do the departure is equal to sine course. So laging tatandaan, sa sine course, laging gagamitin yung ating quadrantal notation. Okay, huwag gagamitin yung true. Okay, so 54.46 divided by sine, ay sorry, yung ating departure pala. Our departure is 314.98 divided by sine course na 54.46. Okay, so the distance will be 314.98 divided by sine 54.46. So ang lalabas yan ay 387.09, or we can do, sabihin natin 387 nautical miles. Okay, so yan yung ating procedure, no? We already solved for the course, which is 300 305.54 or 3052 yung ating course, and our distance, yung distance niya ay 387, and the course going to point A to point B will be 305 degrees. Okay, yung ito travel natin, and the distance is 387. So that is the procedure for middle latitude. It is the combination of plain sailing, parallel sailing, and middle.